In this next portion of the course, and over the next several videos, I'm going to work to get you familiar with the basic night sky. And so what the night sky is, of course, is if you're ever out at night, say camping like this, and you look up, you see this wonderful big black area with all these little dots in there. Some of the dots that you see are going to be stars, and some of them are going to be planets. And there's just a lot of wonderful information to learn and to understand up there. And this is where I'm also going to try to make my plug here to make you into a better camper, because usually when you're camping, this could be you out there, it's one of the times where you're definitely outside at night and that big sky is all around you when you look up. You're with your friends. What a great time it would be to be able to tell your friends something about that night sky. I like to be a little familiar with the night sky because it sort of gives me a sense of ownership and belonging into the larger world. I know that sounds a little corny, but it's true. To be able to look up at the sky and see some of the stars and recognize some of the things up there with sort of a familiar feeling is very satisfying. And so that's what we'll get into in the next few videos, and I hope to turn you into a better camper and someone who can be outside under that wonderful dark sky at night and be able to say something about what you recognize. So it sort of goes like this. If you just look up, say, well, you just get started with this, you just go out and look up, it can be very confusing because all you really see are all these little white dots, and maybe in some cases you might be able to take a little bit of color. Most of the time you can't. This is definitely a overexposed portion of the night sky taken with a camera. But in either case, you look up and see a bunch of blackness, a bunch of little dots up there, and you have to try to make some sense of it. I say again, if you just go out and look up, it can be very confusing. So here's the way I'd like to start with you. We're going to get you familiar with the night sky in sort of a way that you start recognizing patterns. And it's going to work like this. If you saw this image here and I asked you the question, what direction would north be? You'd probably immediately be able to tell me, well, it's this way, right? You'd probably mean to say, oh, north is that way. How do you know that? Because these are a few states. These are four states that you've seen millions of times in the United States. And you know generally how they're oriented with respect to one another. And so you know that the map looks like someone just tilted it, and north would be up that way. So you know that because you're just familiar with this, the pattern of the states. And so we're going to try to get you that way with the stars. Okay, so let's try this one more time. On a 3, 2, 1, tell me what direction you think north is. 3, 2, 1. Where's north? So hopefully if you're paying attention, you immediately said, well, north is going to be down this way. And again, you know that because you're just familiar with the patterns of these states. So the way we're going to start then, I'm going to start you out with probably what I think is the best way to start. Two of the most common features to find in the night sky, at least in the northern hemisphere, so when you're north of the equator, which is probably where most of us are most of the time. Number one is going to be the Big Dipper, and number two is going to be the North Star, and sometimes the North Star is called Polaris. The names are sort of interchangeable, the North Star, Polaris, same thing. And also in this discussion here, we'll get the answer out to question 15, which reads, the North Star is easy to find because it's so bright, right? Like, is that something you're going for? When you go outside at night and see something like this star field, would you pick out the brightest one? Oh, I don't know, maybe this one right here, and go, yep, this must be the North Star because it's so bright. Is that what you would do? Okay, well, we'll see about that. And so the connection between the Big Dipper and the North Star is follows here. The Big Dipper here, Big Dipper, is very familiar to most people, even if you just know nothing about astronomy or you've never tried to go out and sort of navigate in the night sky. Let me tell you why. Because the Big Dipper is the bowl. 1, 2, 3, 4, looks something like this. And if you look at it then, reason why I said it's a bowl is because if you now connect the stars that make up the Big Dipper with some lines like this, it's going to look something like this. So this part here is the handle, and of course this is a bowl. Now the Big Dipper isn't always lined up like this. It always has the bowl shape. So sometimes it might look like this. Other times it might be on its side. Other times it might be clearly upside down. I'm not even able to draw this. It might be upside down like that, or over to the side, you know, something like that. But in either case, it always has sort of that bowl shape. And the other part about the Big Dipper is why we started with the Big Dipper, because it's sort of related to the North Star or Polaris, because these two stars here on the bowl's edge here are known as pointer stars. They're known as pointer stars. How come? Because if you use these two stars sort of like the guide for an arrow, so you sort of imagine an imaginary arrow that goes up from these stars here, they will point at the North Star. That's why they're called pointer stars, because they point to the North Star. And the other sort of interesting aspect of this here is that as you sort of carry yourself to the North Star by following the imaginary pointer stars in this region here, there's definitely sort of a void of stars in this region. So it's very difficult to get confused when you're going out looking for the North Star. So we'll continue this in the next video.